Hello and welcome back. So today we're going to be looking at the programming for the Z3 Siren. Now before we get started, you're going to need the Z3 amplifier, a programming CD or software from online. You're going to need a male-to-male USB cable, as well as the supplied positive and ground wire with the connector for the Z3 Siren. If you buy it new, it will come with it, or used, just make sure it comes with this cable and have it handy so that programming will be much easier. And you also need a 12-volt power source during the configuration as well. So connecting the amplifier is fairly simple. All you'll need to do is take your one end of your male USB cable. You will come right down here where the amplifier says USB. I'm going to go ahead and plug that in. Then you're going to take your positive and negative wire here. You're going to connect this to the back of the amplifier. Make sure it snaps in. And then you'll just take your leads and one to the positive side and one to the negative side of your battery. And then this other end will connect directly to your computer. All right, so once you've downloaded the software and established all your necessary connections, we're going to go ahead and launch the software, which is the Z3 Siren configuration software. So this window will pop open, and if you've already done this before, this will matter a little bit more. If you've not configured your Siren yet, then you won't need to, then you can ignore this for now. But this is pretty much just stating that if you already have a configuration, if you start messing with this one here and not open your previously edited one, then it will default it back to its factory setting. So we're going to go ahead, just for this video, we're going to go ahead and open up our previously configured Siren here. Actually, first, we'll go ahead and show you kind of what these do. So this is the slide switch. So by giving it a right click, you can tell it what you want to do. You can activate your horn ring down here. You can have auxiliary functions here in the blue column. You can have those activate, as well as the arrow stick. You can choose whether you want your arrow stick to come on during that time or not. And for each phase, you can select what you want to happen. So we'll go ahead and open up our previous, which is here. All right, so I have the level 3 on progressive, which means that each LED will stay lit as the slide switch progresses. Here. There we go. And 2 and 3. So I'm not sure if you caught that. So level 1, I don't have anything coming on. But level 2, A and B come on. And then level 3, A, B, C, and D come on, which are these 4 here. So that's all programmable. You can all set those. And then if you were to click on whale, you can choose it, whether you can choose whale to come on level 3, which I do not have that set on right now. You can also sample the different sirens you want to hear as well. So for each of these, you can choose again if you want something else to come on, or if you just want the siren by itself, and if you want the siren to be non-operable unless the slide switch is in position 3. That is also an option here. So, and then you can choose what your manual is. I have it on hit and go, but you can choose scroll, manual whale, or whale stop. Also hands-free. You can actually, I have mine programmed. I believe it's H. I have that programmed as, yep, yeah, there it is right there, hands-free. So you can have it either scroll, manual whale, or whale stop. And also the siren inactive function, it's on manual whale. Air horn, same thing. And then each of the buttons, you can have them come on or off, or you can have them, in other words, you can use them, not use them. You can set them to whatever you want them to be. Also, arrow stick, you can choose how you want your arrow stick to light up. I like the build and collapse, but you can keep it on building. You can build 3 flash, and then the traveling ball. So, anyway, and then you can choose your rate too. So for each, the left, center, and right, you can select whatever you want those to be. Also, if you hold your cursor over it too, actually no, those are these only. If you hold your cursor over it, it'll tell you what you have programmed. So, and then whether you want dimming or not, and then the flash as well. You can choose what flash you want. I like standard myself, but you can have different options here. So. Probably the most difficult part about the programming for this Siren is the slide switch. Just making sure that it's doing what you want it to do. So, because down here under general configure, there's a lot of things to choose from. So, like from remote, you can set load management, you can set your thresholds, dropout delay, siren lock, whether that's if you put your vehicle into park, if you want the siren to stop. And again, this is the level 3 switch. You can go straight to aero stick. You can choose what type of aero stick you have. So if you have a 6 head, 5 head, or 8 head, you can choose that here. Horn ring. Probably you can choose polarity. Here's your park kill. Your light alert. So this will beep if you have something active. So you can set it to only level 3, or you can do all 3, level 1, 2, and 3. Or on the auxiliary switches too. I think it's rather annoying for me, so I don't have it set at all. And also sleep mode too. I believe that's where the back panel dims out, but I'm not 100% sure. I haven't tried it myself. And if you live in California, California 13, Title 13. So, and then once you have your desired configuration set up, then you can go up here to save. You can save all your work, and then you go to transfer, and you can transfer whatever you've done to your unit. So in this case, I have, since the unit's already hooked up, the transfer has been successful. Now I haven't changed anything, so it's still going to stay the same. And this is your loading bar down here, so you can see your progress. And also right here, if your siren is not connected, it will be in red and say siren or no siren detected. I believe that's what it says. And also, if you have a configuration on your amplifier and you want to put it into here, load it in here and just hit extract, and it will take all that information from the siren amplifier and drop it into this software here. So if you really sit down and kind of study it, there's a lot of things you can do with it. And if you want to read this too, there's a description for or a general description. So I've already read through it. But and also, actually, I just noticed this now, there's an EU lock as well. I'm not 100% sure what that does, but probably something in the UK. So anyway, that's a brief introduction to the programming for this siren. Hope you found that helpful, or if you were curious as to how this was done, this is how to do it. So stay tuned, and we will be back again shortly with another video.